Hello, my name is Bob Plankers, and it is my pleasure to demonstrate migrating using cross vCenter vMotion, a VM that has a virtual trusted platform module on it, or a vTPM. A vTPM is useful for storing workload secrets. It uses VM encryption to write the secrets securely to disk. When you're doing a migration or a replication between VMware Cloud Foundation instances, maybe a primary site and a disaster recovery site, or VMware vSphere sites, you want to preserve the data that's in the vTPM. You don't want that lost because it's important secrets that your workloads care about. So how do we do that? Turns out it works great in vCenter server, cross vCenter vMotion. So let me demonstrate the problem to start with when there's incompatible key providers there. So we will go and at the destination, we'll choose import VMs. I've already defined a new vCenter server and saved it to save us some time, as well as a lightweight demo VM here that's only a 1 megabyte or so. So it's telling me there are compatibility issues, and we look at those. Key provider vCenter-A is not found. Well, that makes a lot of sense because this isn't vCenter A, this is vCenter 8. So we need to import that key provider. For a standard key provider, I would just redefine that key provider on my target as well. For a native key provider, in this case, what we can do, we'll go to the source, my vCenter A. I'll go to configure and then key providers. I've got two key providers here, but vCenter A is the default. What I can do is I can back this one up. Probably a good idea to give it a password. I'm not going to for speed here, but you should. It's downloaded that file, no problem. I can go over to my destination now, choose vCenter, the object in the inventory, configure, key providers, and I can restore this file. Give it a password if I had saved it with one. And then here we go. It's got a warning. That warning can be cleared by backing it up. No problem whatsoever. And now I'm ready to go. My normal one is default, but we've got access to the cryptographic keys that are part of the source. So let's try this again. Find my demo virtual machine, my template. Compatibility checks succeeded. That is a good sign. I'll just specify my vSAN data store. And we'll put it in there. We'll give it a destination network. And then away we go. Interestingly enough, when you import it, the status shows up on the source. So we'll go back over here and that's completed. It is a very small VM after all. And we can take a look. So encryption, encrypted with native key provider vCenter A. Well, one of my other VMs has the other key provider, and perhaps I would like this VM. Perhaps this VM is going to stay in this location on a more permanent basis. It's not just a replicated copy, but it's now a permanent resident over here. What we can do is when with the default vCenter 8.1 key provider that I've got configured here, that's this is my preferred one for this location. So what I can do, that's set to the default, I can choose VM policies and then re-encrypt. And this will re-encrypt the virtual machine. It will change the key provider and change the encryption of the data encryption key. There are two encryption keys used in VM encryption. There's a key encryption key and a data encryption key. And this changes the key encryption key that protects the data encryption key. That seems complicated. For more information, see the links down below. And we've got links to other presentations that explain this, as well as Q&A and other questions, information about the key providers and such. But regardless, I now have both of my VMs in this environment on the key provider that I desire. So if I want to keep things clean, what I can do is I can go and delete the old one. Now that I know that there's nothing using it. There. Now I've done a migration. That VM is over here. it's running and it still has its vTPM and all of its data. Thank you for watching. We appreciate you. And for more information, like I said, see the links down below. Take care.